Welcome to the Zhangyang Sports Center, host venue for judo at these Chengdu Games, where we've had three fabulous days of competition, and today sees the grand finale. And it's the men's and women's team events. And so we come to the women's team final to decide the gold and the silver medals. It's Japan against Germany. Every match is a best of five. Now you'll notice just the four players for Japan. So already Germany go into this with a bye. So Annika Würfel, who should be fighting in the under 52 kilo, gets a bye. And we will skip straight away to the under 57 kilo category. It'll be Leila Gerbel facing Akari Omori of Japan. I must say, I'm extremely surprised that the Japanese have only put four players up for this. They've got an incredibly strong team and strength in depth as well. Oh, she's managed to get that in, and it's a wazari to Omori. She's trying to get her leg free, get the hold on. So, Omori wazari up. German tried the Marotti Sienaga, didn't come off, and now she's in trouble. Omori tries to turn her over. And Omori looks like she's done enough with that hold to take that first fight of the match and bring the score to 2-1. So fight number three of the match, Agata Schmidt up against Kirari Yamaguchi. Second Shido for the German. 10 seconds to go. Can one of them pull off a winning throw? Time's up. We go to golden score. But going into golden score with two Shidos is not great for Agata Schmidt. Ponsianagi, she pulls it off, but there's no score, and instead has been caught, but only momentarily by the German. Yamaguchi's bundle of energy, isn't she? Now the referee waiting for some information from the video commission. They're going to be looking at that throw. Oh, it was seeing Moroti Sionagi. You can see, did she get her onto her back? Yes, she did. It was good enough to put Japan 2-1 up. Fight number four of this match for gold and silver. Samira Bock in blue for Germany, Mayu Honda in the white for Japan, and a victory for Honda will win Japan another gold medal here. Now this is a repeat of the individual final in the under 70 kilo category from the other day. And that time Honda came out on top, snatching the gold from Bock. So the German looking for revenge here. Honda showing some real strength there, lifting the German, lifting her opponent off the mat. Japanese women have won the last three team events at FISU University Games. And now Mayu Honda is trying to make it four in a row, which is an extraordinary achievement. Japanese by far dominating university judo. Professional level, competition's evened out somewhat in recent years, but Japanese still dominant within university judo. Into the last minute, two more shidos handed out there, but it does mean that Bock has two shidos to her name. As the attempted throw goes in, Honda makes it so difficult to throw her. She's so steady and balanced on her feet, so strong. And now she's trying to get a hold on the German. And the hold is on. And it's off, and Mate's called. So we're into golden score in this third fight of the match. Any score now for Mayu Honda of Japan will win her country another gold medal here in the judo. Honda really proving how strong she is in her groundwork, but can't get that leg free. But she has now, and the hold is on. She's now just 5 seconds away from another gold medal for Japan. Bok can't do anything about that. It's a Wazari. And that is enough. Let's wait for that confirmation. Well, Bok put up a great fight, but congratulations to the Japanese and Mayu Honda, who wins Japan's 10th gold medal in the judo at these games, and that equals their record for World University gold medals in judo. Well done to all our medalists. Japan's women then bringing their medal total in judo here in Chengdu to 7. Germany's women, meanwhile, well, they can boast winning 5 of the country's 6 judo medals here in Chengdu. And on the screen right now are, in fact, the top 3 countries in the medal table overall. So to the men's team final. The grand finale to these 4 days of judo at the Chengdu World University Games. Uzbekistan will face Japan. Taiki Nakamura will represent Japan. He faces Abdurakhim Nutfulov of Uzbekistan. Nutfulov is here, he means business, doesn't he? This is his second bronze medal match of the competition. He lost the last one, but he's doing everything right. Can he get himself free and get the hold on? It's not going to happen on this occasion. Terrific throw that's only got him a Wazari. And another one. No score from the referee. He's got him into an arm lock now. Nutfulov in control. He taps out. It's 1-0 to Uzbekistan against the Japanese in this first fight of the final. Second up then is Ishihara of Japan against Saparov of Uzbekistan. Oh, in he goes, Ponce with the Marotti Sionaga, and the arm has gone up for an Ippon. And that is confirmed victory to Ishihara. And that squares the match to 1-1. So up next, Yoshita Hojo of Japan against Nurbek Murtazov of Uzbekistan in the under 81 kilo category. Oh, and already with just a few seconds gone in this match, Hojo gets in a terrific throw. He beat Murtazov the last time they met for gold, and he beats him again this time to put Japan 2-1 up in this match. So it's Tangriev of Uzbekistan facing Kazuki Nakanishi of Japan. And Nakanishi knows that victory for him will mean a gold for Japan. Japan 2-1 up going into this. They need just one more victory. Will it come in this fight? Or can Tangriev of Uzbekistan keep his team in the fight? Nakanishi already a bronze medalist here. He won the individual event, and now he's just a victory away from a second medal, this time a golden one for his team. Well, you could hear from the microphones that are on the edge of the mat how much that must have hurt. Tangriev just catching his breath. 19 years old. And now the only thing standing between a gold or a silver medal for his country. Hard to believe we're not even halfway through this fight. Tangriev so much taller than Nakanishi. Thank you. Oh, he's turned him over. It's got him a Wazari. So Japan and Nakanishi, a Wazari up with just 30 seconds to go. And the gold medal is in their grasp. Tangriev with everything to do and very little time to do it in. Tensions rising as the clock counts down into the final 10 seconds. Tangriev needs to do something, or the gold medal belongs to Japan. He goes for the Tomonagi. It's not going to happen. The time is up. And Kazuki Nakanishi has a Wazari on the board. And now everyone just waits for the final result confirmation from the referee. And there it is, a big cheer goes up from the Japanese team. Japan have won the gold medal. And so a clean sweep for the men and the women of Japan in the team event. Japan on the top step of the podium for a record haul of judo gold medals at a single games, 11 in total here in Chengdu. For Korea, that bronze is their fourth of the competition, added to their four silvers and two golds. Their medal total sees them finish second in the judo table.